electrostatic shielding. Aim: to demonstrate electrostatic shielding. Materials required: laboratory stand, electroscope, tape, metal can, glass rod, wire, silk cloth. Procedure: take a glass rod and rub it with the silk cloth. Bring the glass rod into contact with the knob of the electroscope. Please note that the deflection in the electroscope indicates that it is charged. Remove the glass rod from the electroscope. Again, rub the glass rod with the silk cloth and bring it near the knob of the charged electroscope. Please note, an increase or decrease in the deflection of leaves indicates whether the nature of the charge on the rod is similar or opposite to that on the charged electroscope. Remove the charged rod away from the electroscope and make sure the electroscope is still charged. Fix one end of a wire on the body of the metal can with the help of tape. Now attach the grounded metal can to the laboratory stand in such a position that its open end is towards the ground. Gradually lower the metal can in such a manner that it completely covers the knob of the charged electroscope. Fix the other end on the ground. Take care that the metal can does not touch the knob or the body of the electroscope while it covers the knob from all sides. Rub the glass rod with the silk cloth and bring it near the knob of the electroscope in such a manner glass rod is positioned on the outside of the metal can. Ensure the charged rod does not touch the metal can and observe the results. Observation: there is no change in the deflection of the leaves of the electroscope when we bring the glass rod near the knob after lowering the metal can above it. Conclusion: the earthed metal can provide an electrostatic shield to the charged electroscope. That means the presence of a charged glass rod near the knob or outside of the metal can does not affect the leaves of the electroscope. This is known as electrostatic shielding.